An electromagnetic pulse, also known as an EMP, is perhaps the greatest existential threat to North America and modern electronic civilizations everywhere, able to cause widespread destruction and cascading failures in the critical infrastructures we so heavily depend on today. That is the warning given by Dr. Peter Vincent Pry, who is the executive director of the Congressional EMP Commission, who joins us today. Dr. Pry, the first question I want to ask you is, are we heading toward an EMP catastrophe here in the U.S.?
Absolutely, we are. It's as real as the sun rising up in the morning and as near to us as two North Korean satellites that are currently orbiting over our nation at the optimum altitude to do a nuclear EMP attack.
Wow, that's frightening. Okay, so from what you're telling me, it sounds like the threat has actually increased in recent years, given that there are two satellites now orbiting in the right trajectory, I take it.
And it's also increasing for another reason. Every 10 years, the semiconductor revolution, the microelectronics revolution, continues on its pathway, on its progressive positive pathway, producing better and better electronics that can operate faster and faster and at lower and lower levels of energy. You know, this is one of the things that has accounted for the great prosperity and the revolutionary developments in electronics that have made our lives better and made our country wealthier and more prosperous. But while this is going on, the very technological revolution that is feeding our prosperity is also making us more vulnerable. Because as electronics get smaller and faster and operate on lower and lower energy levels, they also become proportionately more vulnerable to EMP. So you have both of these things happening. Bad guys are getting nuclear weapons and more capabilities to inflict EMP attacks. Mother Nature, we haven't talked about that yet, but the sun can cause an EMP catastrophe as well. And we are overdue for a geomagnetic storm for the sun. So the likelihood of that increases with every day that passes. And our vulnerability is increasing because the critical infrastructures upon which we depend for our prosperity and survival, as they actually improve, they are also simultaneously becoming more and more vulnerable to this kind of attack. To give you an example, when the nuclear EMP phenomena was discovered by the United States in 1962 during the Starfish Prime event, you know, the electronics of the day were basically vacuum tube technologies. Those technologies were over 10 million times less vulnerable, 10 million times less vulnerable than the modern electronics that we depend upon today.
So that was actually something you mentioned in your recent presentation to the Canadian Parliament. So in 1961 and 62, just to set the background, the USSR had conducted several tests in Kazakhstan above their territory. And you write that they deliberately destroyed the electric grid and other critical infrastructures over an area larger than Western Europe. So this is a very large area. And I think, as you just said, the U.S. Congressional EMP Commission had sort of simulated that same exact threat or situation here in today's environment. And given today's electronic infrastructure, we were 1 million times more vulnerable than that of the 1960s experiment conducted by the USSR.
Hi, everybody. John Loeffler here. You know, you've just been listening to a free preview of the Financial Sense Insider Premium Edition. Do you need help making sense of the market? I mean, you've heard the old adage, it's a jungle out there. Well, you know, you can join our premium weekday service and you'll gain access to leading experts, analysts, and market technicians on what's driving the markets, the economy, and your future. You can get all of that by subscribing today at financialsense.com. That's financialsense, S-E-N-S-E, like you're trying to make sense of something, .com. And click subscribe to join our premium weekday service. You won't regret it.